This is Rhino warzewitschii. This one utilizes more streams and seepages and stuff where they reproduce more moving water.
Well, this light, its pupils should restrict down. So then you'll see more of the action. The iris has got the real beautiful iris. Bright white with like a real dark, real strong black kind of reticulation.
So this is the tadpole of the rocket frog?
Yep, one of our rocket frogs. This species is Silverstoneia flotator, commonly referred to as rocket frogs. The ghost glass frog, Sachatamia ilex.
So again, he's been probably more focused on territory, and these frogs are definitely territorial.
Down here about 100 meters further down, this comes into the Sachatamia River. And go down to the Sachatamia River, see what's going on around there in the Sachatamia River.
Okay.
So this here is Craugastor crassidigitus, the thick-fingered dirt frog. Very common species in the understory in the forest. Again, direct developers, so they lay their eggs and little froglets hatch out. They skip like the aquatic tadpole stage.
Yeah, Pristimantis cerasinus, Duellmanohyla, rufioculis. Obviously, rufi for red and oculus like eyes, so red eyes. So it's, but, you know, up in their habitats are fairly common, but you know, not probably that's seen by a lot of people because a lot of people get up into these kind of habitats.
They're cute.
Yeah, they're cute. I really like these little guys. They're cute little things. And just called again down below.
They're kind of quacking.
Like, right. There's even another one right there on that leaf right there. Down below here.
Oh yeah. Those eyes are great.
Mm-hmm.
This is called Pristimantis ridens, the laughing dirt frog. Ridens means like laughing.
That'd be a good name for a band, the laughing dirt frogs.
There you go. Ideas you get out of hanging out with a frog guy. So this is Smilisca phaeota. It's called a masked tree frog. It's in the same family, tree frog family, but it's, the hourglass is Dendrosophus, so a different genus. exhibit a little bit of what's known as metachrosis, like the ability to change colors.
Oh.
Metachrosis, that's cool. Mm-hmm.
Like Isla Versicolor.
Exactly, yeah. That's a classic example of metachrosis, or a metachromatic species. There's another species we have here that we typically see more in these areas, kind of these pasture areas, which is actually a decent amount bigger. It's called Bulitiglossa striatula, the striated salamander.
That's a great shot. I'm getting a good shot right now.
Good, man. Oh, these are great. They're so charismatic. They're just cute.
They're so cute. Mm-hmm. That's great. Those are some serious legs. Is there a common name for these?
The lemur leaf frog.
Lemur leaf frog.
Another one down there. Okay, now we have a really nice dense population of them. several sites in the reserve. We have five different sites that are breeding here in the reserve.
A very successful translocation and, you know, just kind of reintroduction type thing, you know. It's nice, there's not too many success stories in reintroductions and critically endangered amphibians. One of the few real successful, was one of the few that have been really successful.
This is a Sachatamia ilex. You got it, they crept it, kind of rub with their back, their ankles, and pull it off.
Oh, that was it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Cool, I'm glad you found that. I probably wouldn't have seen that many video for a poison frog.
But these guys, the ones here usually are in like the leaf litter a little over here, but even these ones here tend to be a little more skittish, semi-hidden, you know, and they don't seem to be as bold as some of the other populations of Pumilio.